Hey, what's going on, guys? The Horror Man finally back with some of my Christmas haul. I'm sorry for the delay, guys, but I've been spending the last few days just sort of enjoying the time off from work, you know, unwinding from Christmas, and actually trying to figure out how I was going to show my entire Christmas haul. And I realized that I just can't, not in one video anyway. I got some movies, books, Funko Pops, movie posters, autographs. I even got this really awesome Joe Bob's Last Call t-shirt. And I inevitably came to the conclusion that I just cannot show it all in one video. So for this video, I've chosen a selection of the movies I received at Christmas. First up is a DVD I of course already own. It's Nightbreed. This is the Warner Brothers snapper case. But as you can see, this one is signed by Clive Barker. It also contains an insert inside which Clive Barker also signed. This was a gift from my wife, and as I unwrapped it on Christmas morning, I was a bit confused at first because I didn't see the autograph. I was wondering why she would have bought me another Nightbreed DVD since she knows I own this one. And then I saw the signature. It was such a cool gift and a very nice addition to my DVD and autograph collection. And now onto some Blu-rays. I finally got Mandy. I've heard nothing but great things about this one, and I am super psyched to check it out. Here's another movie I've been wanting for a long time. It's Shock 'Em Dead. Now, I've heard this Blu-ray does not have the best transfer, but it's sort of to be expected, since I believe this Blu-ray was just transferred from the VHS. So it's not really a high-def transfer, but it's the best we're gonna get, I guess, so really glad to have it. Here's another one about which I've been hearing really good things. Summer of 84. This one sounds right up my alley. Here's one I know my buddy Andrew from Andrew's Crypt will be happy to see. Digging Up the Marrow. And I say that because it's directed by Andrew's favorite director, Adam Green. This is the only released Adam Green film that I did not own, so I'm glad to add this one to the collection. I should also mention that not only didn't I own the film, but I've never actually seen it either. Next is a movie I've been wanting ever since I found out it was released on Blu-ray. It's Star Time. I remember watching this one on VHS when I was younger. I always enjoyed this one. I always loved the mask. There's something very simple and creepy about it. I love the atmosphere and setting in this one, and I cannot wait to revisit it after all these years. And last, but certainly not least, is the Puppet Master Trunk. Now, I was never ever really expecting to own this one because of the price. But after opening gifts at home with my wife and son on Christmas morning, we always go to my parents' house to have breakfast and open gifts there. After opening the rest of our presents, my mother hands me a big box and tells me it's my big gift. So I unwrapped it excitedly and this was inside. I have to say, I was completely blown away. I'm sure you guys have already seen this, but just in case, I'll open it up quickly and show you what it looks like inside. First of all, this thing is very well made. It's sturdy, it's hard, you're just not damaging this. So I unlatched both of these and then it opens just like this. And how cool is that? So inside here you have all of the Puppet Master films on Blu-ray except for the newest. It also comes with a booklet up top there, and then you also have a little figure of Blade. I'm not going to take everything out right now. There are plenty of unboxing videos of this online, so if you're interested in seeing all of the individual cases, please check one of those out. Maybe in the future I'll do an obscure oddities video and unbox this if anyone's interested. So that's all for this update, guys. But before I end this video, I want to let everyone know that my Slashback series, the Ultimate Slasher Challenge, will be starting tomorrow. If you plan on participating, you don't have to do anything yet, so don't worry. Just stay tuned for tomorrow's video and I'll explain everything. I really think it's going to be a good time for all involved. If you love slasher films like I do, then please consider participating. I welcome any and all who are interested. Be sure to check out tomorrow's Slashback video to find out how. So what do you guys think of this update? Comment below and let me know. Thanks for watching.